Morning students, we were doing exercise 10.2 and today we will do some question of same exercise. I'll start with 18, 19 and 20. I'll do these three. Let's look 18 question. Question 18 says PAB is a midpoint of line segment between axes. Show that the equation of line is x upon a plus y upon b equal to 2. It's a very good question. This is if PAB is a midpoint of segment between axes. So what segment between axes is very important. Let me explain something. These are two axes and this is the segment. This is the line, and if you talk about this portion AB in middle of axis, this is called the segment between axes. So I would say AB is a segment and this is the point which is midpoint. Suppose it is a midpoint and according to question it is AB. So AB is a midpoint of the segment between the axes. We have to show that equation of this line is x upon a plus y upon b equal to 2. How we can find this particular question? In this question only we are given that PAB is a midpoint of the segment between the axes. So how we can find AB is very simple thing. I tell you again. I say suppose this distance is suppose capital I say something change symbol I take. I cannot take small a small b. So I'll take some other value like small r and small s I'm taking. Suppose it is small r and this distance is small s. And if you will focus on the form of line, I tell you it looks like intercept form of line. What do you write in intercept form? This was a, this was b, then equation of line is x upon a plus y upon b equal to 1. But in this case only, if you will talk about, I say that I take r, I take s, I cannot take a and b because a and b has come in the other sense. That's why I am taking small and small s. Then this answer will be x upon r, y upon s equal to 1. That is simple. So I will find r and s. It's very simple, I tell you. Look at, if this distance is r, meaning this intercept on the x axis is r, so I say a will be. So a will be r comma 0 and this will be 0 comma s because this distance is s and this distance is r. So this was simple assumption. So I start writing here, let intercepts on x and y axis cut off by line r, small r and small s. So a will be r comma 0 and b will be 0 comma s. That's it. Now I will come on the main point, that how we can find r and s. This is intercept on both axes. So it's very simple. PAB is a midpoint of AB. Since P small AB is a midpoint of AB, so I use a midpoint formula. So what is the midpoint formula? By midpoint formula, what is the midpoint law? P is a midpoint. This plus this upon 2. You know A1 plus A2 by 2, B1 plus B2 by 2. So 0 plus R upon 2. This is the midpoint law you studied in class 10th. 0 plus R upon 2. This is the midpoint formula. A1, B1, A2, B2, I say. Or x1, y1, x2, y2, I say x1 plus x2 by 2 comma y1 plus y2 by 2. And this will be compared with, you can understand, this will be compared with AB. Because it is given. PAB is the midpoint which is given. You can compare. So on comparing, I will get r upon 2 is equal to a and r upon 2 is equal to, sorry, s upon 2 is equal to b. So we can find r equal to 2 and s equal to 2b. You have got very important thing that this is a 2 and this is 2b. Now equation of line in intercept form is x upon r, y upon s is equal to 1. It was intercept form because this time intercepts are r and s. So value of R is we got 2A and value of S 2B equal to 1. Only 2 is a common which can be transferred this side. So x upon A plus y upon B equal to 2 is there, which is a required equation as per question. So I think you have got the important question. This is actually important one, but it is the easier thing. So hope you have understood all. Guys, now we'll move on the second upcoming question here. Let's look today's second question. Question number 19. Question says, point RHK divides the line segment between the axis in 2:1:2. Find the equation of line. This is actually the same question. In the 18th question, it was that PAB, which is a midpoint of segment. This time is a little bit change, that RHK divides the line segment between the axis. The terminology is same, but this time the point RHK is given and it is dividing the axis in 1:2. So I don't think it's any special which will trouble you. I think it's very easy that between the axis we have a line AB suppose, and a point RHK suppose here is dividing the whole line in 1:2. So 1, I am simply writing 1 and 2. We can also make R here and 1:2 may possible. So it doesn't matter that where you are pointing R. If I am pointing R here, it means that it is 1 and it is 2. So according to question, that RHK is a point which is dividing to the line between the axis, it means that portion AB between the axis in ratio 1:2, we have to find the equation of line. Same thing will be coming. Let me explain. I took R and S. You can take here A and B, because in last question, AB was it came with the other sense, that's why I took intercepts R and S. In this question, AB is nothing anywhere, that's why you can take A and B. But okay, with the same continuity, I just want to take R and S. So I start with the same working. This is R, so A will be as usual R and 0. This is S, this will be 0 and S. So I start at intercept cut up by line on axes are R and S. So A will be R comma 0 and B will be 0 comma S. Since RHK is a point such that AR comma RB is equal to 1:2. Can you see that R is a point, AR and RB have a ratio 1:2. So by internal division, what I am doing, internal division formula, this already you studied in class 10th. Even in last question I use a midpoint formula, because that the point was midpoint in last question, but this time it is not a midpoint, it is dividing whole AB in 1:2. So I use a division law. So what is the division law? That R, it is x1, y1, x2, y2, mn. So formula, mx2, 1 into x1, y1. So this formula is mx1 plus mx2. It was just like what? I tell you again, x1, y1, x2, y2. This is m, this is n. mx2 plus nx1 upon m plus n like that. M y2 plus n y1 upon m plus n like that. So I use a same thing, 1 into 0, 2 into R upon 2 plus 1. Second, 1 into S, 2 into 0 upon m plus n. So if we'll focus on that, 2R upon 3, S upon 3 is equal to R, this is HK. This is the point which we obtained by the division law, and this is the point which is already given. Can you compare? So 2R upon 3 is equal to H and S upon 3 equal to K. Find R from here. Find the value of R from here. So this will be R equal to 3H by 2 and S will be, it's a 3K. So after finding these two, I would speak frankly that equation of line will be x upon r plus y upon s equal to 1. This is a simple formula because r and s I took intercepts. So I am using intercept formula. So x upon, what is the value of r? It is 3h by 2. And what is the value of s? It is 3k equal to 1. You can drop your answer right here. You can simplify by your convenient. So I think you have got the concept and it was so easy question. Okay. Now let me tell you the last question of the exercise. Same exercise I'm telling you. 20th one. What 20th question says? By using the concept of equation of line, prove that three points are collinear. So I don't want to tell you this because three points are collinear. One can easily find it. The three points are collinear. You will just find if slope of AB and slope of BC are same. I tell you one interesting fact here. When the slope of any two lines are equal, that lines will be parallel. So I just want to tell you this question. Look at question number 20. We have three points we have. Suppose A point I'm taking 3, 0, B I'm taking -2, -2. C I am taking 8, 2, and we have to show that these three points are collinear. So first of all, what I will do now, I have three points A, B, C. I will find the slope of AB. First, by definition of slope of two point, slope of AB. How will find slope of AB? That is simple. Formula, you know, y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. So, -2 minus 0. And -2 minus 3. Lastly, it's a -2 upon minus 5, 2 by 5. And in next time, you will write slope of BC. Slope of BC. Same formula. y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. y2 minus y1, 2 plus 2, x2 minus x1, 8 plus 2. So it's a 4 by 10, 2 by 5. What do you think? That slope of both lines are equal. Slope of AB and slope of BC. You will write here, since slope of AB equal to slope of BC. What you will take out the conclusion? Whenever the slope of any two lines are same, they are parallel. So AB will be parallel to BC. You should surprise that how it possible. B is a common point there. You cannot draw the line parallel where B is a common. So it concludes that when any point is common, the three points are collinear. Since I write here, point B is a common. Therefore, I can say that A, B, and C are collinear point. Because you cannot draw them parallel because one point is common. So when one point is common, you have to conclude and take out the result that points are collinear point. Okay. So from my side, I have finished the exercise. Now I'll move on the third exercise. Some concepts first I will tell you, and then we'll have some questions. So very good exercise this is. So first of all, I again put your attention, students, towards the types of line. You know, I taught you lots of things. Y equal to mx plus c. This was a slope intercept form. Second, y minus y1 equal to mx minus x1. It's a point slope form, also called one point form. Third, y minus y1, y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1, x minus x1, it is a 2-point form. Fourth, x upon a plus y upon b equal to 1, it is a pure intercept form. Fifth, x cos alpha plus y sin alpha equal to 1, this is the normal form. Major 5 types I have taught you. So what I am going to tell you, if we are using one of the concept, one of the type, ultimately we get answer, we get equation of line in general form. General form. So, what is general form? I taught you ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. This is general form. You know, whatever or whichever formula or type you are using in question according to the condition, your answer, final answer, will be look like general form, like this one. So my question is, if general form will be given and if you will be told to find the slope, or you will, suppose you are told to find the intercept on the y-axis, suppose you are told to find the intercept on both the axes, suppose you are told the length of normal, x cos alpha plus y sin alpha equal to p, sorry, it's a length of normal. Suppose you are told to find the angle made by normal with the x-axis alpha. So what I mean to say, the recently these two are not in very good sense, but first, fourth and fifth are very important. What I am telling you, that this is a general form. Now in upcoming concept, you will be provided a general form and you have to find this time slope on the, definitely slope is a very unique meaning, slope. This is intercept on a y-axis, these are intercepts on a both axis, and this is a particular angle alpha, which is actually angle made by normal with the x-axis, and length of the perpendicular drawn from origin to the line. So five things you may be asked. So by this general form we have to find this one. So definitely I tell you one simple trick, one simple sentence, try to get this. If you will be told to find slope or intercept on y-axis, you change your equation in this format. I tell you. So suppose that I start with, you have an ax plus by plus c equal to 0, and you are told to find the slope and intercept on y-axis. Suppose this question has come to you, and equation is in general form. Equation is in general form. So how you will find? I tell you, you do only that slope and intercept on y-axis is coming in here. So only you have to replace, you have to change this equation in this format. It's very simple. It is y equal to, okay, we do it. Look at ax plus by plus c, we have equation. So I write first by is equal to minus ax minus c, and y is equal to minus a upon b and c upon b. B, I did transfer b. Can you see this one? It looks like y is equal to mx plus c. So what you conclude? That slope is equal to, find slope is equal to minus a upon b, and intercept equal to minus c upon b. Don't confuse about c and c. That this c is my here, this one, and this is c is constant value. So this was only the method. This was only the method, and you have to follow that one. I put one example. Find the slope and intercept on y-axis of line. Suppose I wrote line here, this one. So how you start? Simple. What you told to find slope and intercept on y-axis, both will follow. I will change my equation general form in the first form. So I'll change here. First, I'll write the equation. I do transfer 3y there. I want to write in the opposite way, 3y and 2x minus 1. And I do transfer 3. Can you get it? It's y equal to mx plus c. So what is m? 2 by 3. And what is c? Minus 1 by 3. That's the answer. Okay. Now I think you have got it. I am very sure that you have got it. Let me write this out. And I want to pull again your attention towards the thing, and draw a trick. That what you got to have? Minus a upon b. So I just request you, you had ax plus by plus c equal to 0. This was the initial equation. And what you got m equal to? What you got m equal to minus a upon b. Can you make a trick? Minus a. Minus is minus. What is a? Coefficient of x. Coefficient of x. And what is b? Coefficient of y. So can you remember the trick? I think yes. Without changing by this way, if you just have to find m, you can use this trick. Minus coefficient of x upon coefficient of y. I tell you one question. Only find slope, not intercept. And question is like that. And if you are just told to find slope, you need not change or convert your equation y equal to mx plus c form. You must know the trick. The trick is, if you want to find the slope is minus coefficient of x 2 upon coefficient of y 3. Keep remember one thing, that your equation must be in general form. Like 2x and 3y must be one side of the equal to sign. Otherwise, if you supposed to have quotient 2x equal to 3y plus 1, and if you remember same formula, it will be wrong, because x and y are either side of equal to sign. So first you transfer, even one is independent, one can be that side or this side, no matter, but x and y should be one side. And then after doing or writing in such a way, you can find the slope. Slope will be minus coefficient of x 2 upon coefficient of y minus 3. Ultimately answer is 2/3. That is a way. That is a way. So hope you have got this very, very interesting and important, that whenever you are having general form of line, you want to find the slope, you can use minus coefficient of x upon coefficient of y. It's a small trick to find m. And if you want to find the slope on intercept on y axis, definitely you have to use y equal to mx plus c, then by which you can find the c easily. Okay, so this was a simple way. Now next, this is interesting. The next, I tell you, this time I have taught you how to convert our general form in this form. Now I am telling you this one, because these two will not come, you don't worry please. These three are important. So about that, I tell you. Suppose you have ax plus by plus c is equal to 0, and you are told to find the intercepts on both axes. Try to understand. Both axes. So whenever the intercept on y axis, if you will be told only y axis, you have to change in y equal to mx plus c. But this time you are told to find the intercept on both axes, meaning you have to convert your general form in the intercept form, where small a and small b are none else but they are intercept on x and y axis respectively. Okay, so I'll change it. I tell you that how we can change. First of all, write the equation. Then second, you will do the transfer of c, minus c there, and divide by minus c all the way. It must be 1 here. Okay, it has come 1. Now x upon a I need, so I have to make x alone upside. So x here with a, so I do transfer a, just denominator of a, and this is a plus sign. Y I must be, you know, keep it alone there. So minus c, and I do transfer b, downside of that c equal to 1. Can you compare? X upon this is, y upon this is equal to 1. These are none else, but these are the intercept on x axis and y axis. Do you know, remember the picture? This is the intercept. This is the intercept. If it is ax plus by plus c, one should know that this portion is minus c upon a, and this portion will be minus c upon b, intercept on x and y x respectively. So I don't think it's a trouble. It was so simple for one and all. I put one example to you guys. 2x minus 3y minus 6 is equal to 0. And question is, find the intercepts cut by the line on the x and y axis. So you have to change your equation like that. How you can change? First of all, you do transfer to the constant value. I want 1 here, so I will divide by 6. If you supposed to have plus 6, it gonna be minus 6, then you will divide by minus 6, because ultimately you need 1 here. So you divide by 6 only. I will do equal to 6 by 6, 1. Very interesting thing is coming here. X upon, it's a 3, 2, 3 is a 6. It's a 2 equal to 1. So I tell you, when you will follow the intercept form, you need plus sign here. But it is a minus sign. So change in, it's a plus, and write minus with this 2. This is very interesting. Meaning intercept can be negative, because intercepts are cutting, suppose here like that. So x intercept will be negative and y will be positive. So here x intercept is a positive, y is a negative. but this is intercept form. So I would finally reply or will give the answer in the form that the intercept on x axis is 3 and intercept on y axis is a minus 2. So this was the question. So hope you have got it. Now the next is very important, and this is the form. It's called normal form. Let me recall your knowledge about that. This was a line. This is O. This is the drawn perpendicular from O to the line, have a distance P. This is P. And this is called normal because it is perpendicular. It's normal. And normal is making angle alpha with the positive direction of x axis. This is alpha. So two things may be asked here, that length of perpendicular drawn from the line, drawn from the origin to the line, have a distance, if you will be asked, point P. And alpha is very unique, that the angle made by the line, made by the normal with the x-axis, positive direction of x-axis, that means alpha you have to find out. So ultimately I would give you one trick that how we can find the answer. Okay, this is actually a unique method, a certain method also. So just keep remember, I tell you here, look at it. It's very interesting this, 3x plus 4y minus 25 is equal to 0. This is my question. And this is definitely general form. This is general form. And question is, find the length of normal drawn to it from the origin. This is my question. Also, question says, also find the angle made by normal with positive direction of x-axis. So all the possible questions I have written on the board, that you have to find P and alpha. So how we can find? Look at. First of all, you will write the equation here. Solution will start because I have list is there. So this is my equation. What you will do first? You will first do 3x plus 4y equal to 25. You want this kind of equation. So how we can do it? I tell you one thing, that you divide by coefficient of x with square, coefficient of y with square. Try to understand. You divide by square of coefficient of x plus square of coefficient of y. You divide by with the square root, and your answer is 9 plus 16, 25 and 5. So remember that the trick, that whenever the general form is to convert into the normal form, what you will do, you have first to transfer the constant term in the right side with the positive sign. It is a minus, it is a positive. It must be positive. If you supposed to have plus 25, it can be minus 25. Then do transfer minus here, make it positive. Why? Because this is going to be P, and P is a perpendicular distance from the origin to the line. So P is always positive. So we will always make this point, this number is positive. So this is fortunate condition, that if this is a minus, it's gonna be plus, so it is automatically now plus sign. You don't have to make it as positive. So 25 is positive, that's very good sign for us. Now what I'll do? We have to convert this equation in the form x cos alpha plus y sin alpha equal to p. What you will remember? Divide whole equation by square root coefficient of x square, coefficient of y square, meaning 5. So divide by 5 in all equations. This is gonna be 3 by 5. This is gonna be 4 by 5. And this is a 5 by 25 by 5. So your answer is 3 by 5x plus 4 by 5 y equal to 5. This is none else but it is x cos alpha. Can you compare? X cos alpha, y sin alpha equal to p. I would frankly say that p is equal to 5. And very interesting fact, x cos alpha. So what is cos alpha? 3 by 5. What is sin alpha? 4 by 5. This is the answer. And if you want to assure about or you want to be you want to check that whether you are correct or not, I tell you sin alpha and cos alpha, these two value we got. Do you remember that sin square alpha plus cos square alpha is 1 in 10th class? It was a famous identity. Can you do sin square alpha meaning 16/25 plus cos square alpha meaning 9/25? 16/25 plus 9/25 equal to 25/25 equal to 1. We have got sin square alpha plus cos square alpha equal to 1, meaning whatever the obtained answer, it is absolutely correct. So sin alpha equal to 4/5, cos alpha equal to 3/5. These two answers we got. Suppose we have to find the angle made by the normal with the positive direction of x-axis, meaning we have to find alpha. So how we can find alpha? That's a major question this is. So I tell you that how you can find alpha. This is sin alpha 4/5, this is cos alpha 3/5. How you find the alpha? So you divide sin alpha by cos alpha. Look at, I tell you. You divide sin alpha by cos alpha, 4/5, 3/5, 5 and 5 cancel. Sin by 5, 10 alpha. Sin by cos 10 alpha equal to 4/3. And alpha equal to, this is actually very strange to you. You haven't seen ever that this is called inverse trigonometry. Whenever 10 alpha equal to 4/3, it's not a specific value in which the value you cannot find in the table, trigonometric table you studied in class 10th. That if you supposed to have 10 alpha equal to root 3, you can reply alpha equal to 60 degree. If you supposed to have it is 1/√3, you can say alpha equal to 30. If you supposed to have 1, you can say alpha equal to 45. But it is 10 alpha equal to 4/3, which is nothing, any particular value in the table, but it is a possible value. You have to reply how you can. You have to transfer to 10 this side. You have to transfer to 10 this side, and when any particular trigonometric function will transfer the next side, again side, either side, opposite side, you have to say inverse. Meaning 10 alpha will be there, alpha is remaining alone, 10 will transfer, 10 inverse 4/3. This is a particular representation of transferring or transpose of any trigonometric function. So this 10 alpha, have alpha here, 10 will transfer, gonna be 10 inverse 4/3. So if you supposed to ask what is alpha, you say it is alpha. So this was my, for my side question. Definitely we would have some question in the book, we will deal them. But this was only the major concept, we have seen it. Remember the method by which we converted our general form in the normal form. So hope you got here. Now we'll have some example.